Hallelujah. We should be excited. Those of you online, we want to welcome everybody online from Manna from Heaven, Remnant of Truth International, wherever you are. If you're just watching, you just happen to accidentally come across this site, I want to encourage you, it was not an accident. It was a divine appointment. Abba is doing some divine things. He is strategizing. He is connecting areas that you would never think would have been connected before. You know, when Abba's doing something, it does not seem to make sense in the beginning. When he begins to do something, it goes totally against the grain of what we probably would assume how things are supposed to work. He likes to have all the glory and all the esteem, all the splendor, all everything to just be pointed towards him and what he has done. So get ready, you guys. We're in for a treat today, not only with praise and worship, but also with the word that will come forth, the season that we're in. I know there's different calendars out there, and people have observed already Shavuot at different times. For here up in this area, Shavuot is tomorrow, and the 49th day of counting up, not counting down, the completion of the seven-week count, the 49th day is today. And for many, it has been a battle during the counting, maybe since day one or from the middle or towards the end. Regardless, it's the 49th day. And I say it like that because you made it. You made it. You made it. So I'm going to open up with a word of prayer before we get started. Abba, we just thank you for this time, for this set apart season, for the season that we're in. This season of empowerment, this season where you are ministering to your people through your spirit in a very powerful way. We thank you for today, this Shabbat. Abba, we know and we receive and we are expecting you to move in the midst of your people, in here, those that are watching, and around the globe, around the planet. Abba, we just pray and we say, have your way today. Let your anointing rest upon the worship team. Let your anointing rest upon everyone that comes in here. Let your anointing, the fresh outpouring of your Ruach, be evident this entire weekend. So we thank you, Abba, and we praise and acknowledge your mighty name. And with a great shout, we all say, amen. Man, if you have a shofar, get your shofars ready. And I want to encourage you guys, the sound of the shofar is the sound of freedom. Because the noise that you hear coming out of the shofar is called a yovel, where we get the word jubilee from. That's the sound the shofar makes. It makes a sound of freedom. Shofar by itself is just the shofar. But notice that a car is just a car unless you turn that thing on. A shofar is just a shofar. An airplane is just an airplane sitting. It takes something or someone to get inside of that to make it come alive. And it's just like you. You're just a physical body without your spirit, who you really are. So the sound of the shofar is the sound of freedom, is the sound of power, and the sound of victory. And how much more to sound the shofar today. So if you have your shofars, let's do this. Hallelujah. On earth as it is in heaven. How many people agree with that? Let's all stand up together. I need everyone with a shofar to come run up here to the front really quick. Run on up here. If you got a shofar, come on up. I need you. We need you. If you got a shofar, come on up. Come on up. We're about to blast this hindering residue of the enemy that keeps trying to mess with the people of Yah. We're going to blast that out of here. The enemy's always trying to do something in the background. So as it is in heaven, let it be on earth. As we're praising and worshiping, you know that in the heavens, the multiple layers of the heavens, the malachim, the messengers, the angels, the powers that be are in agreement, perfecting our praise and our worship that comes from here, ascending up as an offering. And just like Daniel, when he prayed, remember, for 21 days, his prayer was trying to be hindered. And it's the same thing. The enemy knows that we are doing the Father's business here. He hates it. He hates it. You have manna from heaven. You have multiple ministries standing together. Remnant of Truth. We have our brother that's going to be ministering today, Pastor Freddie from Shekinah Fellowship. We have Emet en la Torah. I want to make sure I say it right. We have multiple ministries here. Remnant Remedy. We have Kol Kara Bamidbar. We have multiple ministries that have stepped up to the forefront. Manna and Remnant have been standing side by side, and there's an impact happening because of Abba, not because of us. So right now, in the name of Yahweh Yahushua HaMashiach, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, the one who sits at the right hand of power on high, the very word that was made flesh, the very word that spoke things into existence, the very word that walked the streets of Jerusalem and demonic entities would run. We come in that authority right now. And we bind up any tactics of the enemy. Remember, the battle's never against flesh and blood. So stop looking at flesh and blood as if it's the problem. It is not the problem. If you're looking at a brother and sister, even from the outskirts, and you just don't like them for some reason, it's not them. The battle's in the spirit realm. It's in the spirit. It's not in the flesh. So we bind and rebuke anything that is not permitted in the heavens. We do not allow it to be in our midst. So all demonic entities, you have to go now. Go. As Mashiach spoke, he said, go. Yes. Hallelujah. 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 Let's give Abba a shout. Come on. Praise him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's what I'm talking about. No quitting, no surrendering to the enemy. It's Shabbat. This is our day given to us by Abba himself. Hallelujah. That's how we do it. That's how we do it. As sons and daughters of the kingdom, that's how we do it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, guys. Hallelujah. See that? When the anointing comes, it comes. It comes. Thank you, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, praise Abba. Hallelujah. What an exciting weekend we have, you guys. Tomorrow's going to be a very powerfully packed day. We are expecting. You guys, are you expecting today? We've got to be expecting. Every time we come, we've got to be expecting. You might have been thinking you were alone out on the deep end for a while. But remember, he's out there with you. Abba is out there with you. Mashiach is walking on those same chaotic waters. He's in the darkness, remember? He's in the darkness. That's how the light shines so bright. Be encouraged. I want to encourage everybody. You be encouraged no matter what seems like if it's happening in your life, it is temporary. Look at your neighbor and say, if you can see it, it's subject to change. I hope you heard what I said. If you can see it, it's subject to change. It's not permanent. So thank you, Abba, for this time. Well, we have to say this, and we get to say this. We got one of our own also going to minister today. Abba's doing a work. I see family here. I don't know about you guys. I see a family. All right, I'll go on this side. I see a family right here. I'll go back over here. A family. You want to know when you're amongst family? Want me to tell you? Look at how excited. So don't leave wherever you are. If you're being rubbed the wrong way, it's because you're amongst family. That's how you know you're with family, when things are not going well all the time, according to you and I. You're with family. Brothers and sisters love each other. How many people come from a big family home? Raise your hand. Now, brothers and sisters, if you had multiple brothers and sisters, you're always, as you're growing up, you'd be at one another at one time or another. So you probably hated each other at those moments and disliked each other, but let someone come mess with your family. How close you stick together. You were just fighting over the toy box yesterday. But someone's coming today to mess with your family. You guys stick together tighter than a hand in a glove. We're amongst family. So yes, there'll be times where we don't agree, where we might not even like each other for that day or that week, whatever it is, but we are family. We're a family. And family not only sometimes might fight with one another, but they fight for each other on a greater scale. And that's what we are doing here right now. And it is awesome. So I want to welcome a fellow brother. He's been here for a while, done some great evangelistic work probably in his lifetime. Some things that I've heard about, has even gone overseas to impact people's lives without looking for anything in return. And Abba has done a great work in his heart, in his mind, and even in his ministry. There's transformations that are taking place and so many things happening right now. So without further ado, and don't forget about tomorrow. I almost forgot about the time frame, I should say. Not about the event, not about the Moedim. But don't forget tomorrow from 2 to 5 outside. Many have went to the neighbors to let them know, hey, if it sounds like a thunderstorm or it feels like an earthquake, it's none of the above. It's us right next door making an impact in this region. So the word's already out. The word's out from 2 to 5. If it's raining and it's stormy, then we'll just stay home and you know, because of the rain, right? All right. If it's raining, we're still going to do it. And if we have to, it'll be inside of here so that it's there's no interruptions whatsoever. But rain is always good. But let's all stand. I want to give a warm welcome to his own house. Pastor Freddie from Shekinah Fellowship. Welcome, brother. Hallelujah.
Thank you, brothers. Thank you, thank you. You may be seated. Okay. We're gonna do it in English and Spanish, so that way some people can understand me a little bit. So I want to apologize first with you guys because I've been sick for 3 or 4 days. I'm here. Praise the Lord. So Ada was asking me for the notes and everything, and I got sent the last time because, I mean, was hard for me every time I sit in the desk trying to do this. I was with a lack of, I felt very weak, so I couldn't even read or write. So it was very complicated, but I'm very happy because the Lord has his purpose and we are here right now, so doing his will. So we did it. Okay. Esta es una de las fiestas más importantes.
This is one of the most important feasts
del pueblo de Israel.
For the people of Israel.
Pero es la menos celebrada.
But is the least one celebrated.
Y es una de mis favoritas.
And it's one of my favorite ones.
Me encanta lo que significa Shavuot.
I love what Shavuot means.
Porque me da regocijo.
Because it brings me joy.
Me da alegría.
Happiness.
Me siento bien.
I feel good.
Saber que puedo moverme en el área espiritual.
To know that I can move in the spiritual area realm.
Por el regalo que él nos dio.
With the present that he gave us.
Así es que esta mañana.
So in this morning.
Yo pido a la Ruach HaKodesh.
I ask the Ruach HaKodesh.
Que se mueva en este lugar.
That he'll move in this place.
En cada lugar de donde tú estás.
In every place that you are
at. En cada banca.
In every bench.
Que toque tu corazón.
That he will touch your heart.
Que toque tu vida.
Your life.
Y que avive el fuego.
And that he will revive the fire.
Que hay en tu vida.
That is in your life.
En el nombre poderoso.
In the name, power, in a powerful name.
De Yeshua HaMashiach.
Of Yeshua HaMashiach.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, no sé si podamos proyectarlo, lo mandé allí o lo conecto yo. So can we do it? Can we? Could they put this in the screens? This no. So can you unplug I'm gonna try to connect me, because I send them by email my message. But if you unplug and take the wireless off, so maybe I can connect my tablet here. Oh, it's working. It's not working last time, but good. Okay. So, hoy celebramos.
So today we celebrate.
Y conmemoramos.
And commemorate.
La entrega de la Torah.
The giving of the Torah.
La Torah mal conocida como ley.
The Torah, very well known as law.
La Torah en hebreo.
Torah in Hebrew.
Es Jireh Ve'moreh.
Is Jireh Ve'moreh.
Nos habla de dirección.
It talks to us about direction.
Y nos habla de guianza.
And guidance.
Si decimos que no estamos bajo la ley.
If we say that we're not under the law.
Estamos diciendo.
We are saying.
Que no estamos.
That we are
not. Bajo Jireh Ve'moreh.
Under Jireh Ve'moreh.
No estoy bajo la dirección.
That I'm not under the direction.
Y no estoy bajo la guianza divina.
And that I'm not under the divine direction of
Yahweh. Lo cual por lógica ya no suena correcto.
Which by logic it doesn't even sound good anymore.
Pero por la mal traducción.
But because of the bad translation.
Hemos creído que estamos atados.
We have believed that we are
atados, like tied, like
tied.
A,
thank you.
Bajo una maldición.
Under a curse.
Y esa maldición que
and
nos dio
curse,
nuestro Señor allá en el monte Sinai.
And that curse that he gave us over there at Sinai.
Y no, amados.
And no.
Esa entrega de Torah.
That giving of Torah.
Fue para hacernos libres.
Was to make us free.
No para atarnos.
Not to tie us up.
Ya que estábamos atados en un pueblo de pecado.
Since we were tied up in a sinful nature.
En un pueblo de esclavitud.
In a people of slavery.
Y él nos hizo libres.
And he made us free.
Para llevarnos cautivos hacia él.
To take us captive to him.
Cautivos a su obediencia.
Captive to his obedience.
Porque esa obediencia.
Because that obedience.
Nos hace libres.
Makes us free.
Libres a cosas buenas.
Free to good things.
Libres a donde queremos estar.
Free to where we want to be.
No atados a la miseria.
Not tied to misery.
Sin ley.
Without law.
Sin Torah.
Without Torah.
Sin esperanza.
Without hope.
Pero Torah,
but Torah
significa dirección,
means direction,
significa guianza,
guidance.
Es algo que todos queremos.
It's something that we all want.
Es algo que todos buscamos.
Something that we all seek.
Pero la mayor parte de la gente lo rechaza.
But most people reject it.
El Señor habló.
He spoke.
Todas estas palabras.
All of these words.
Diciendo.
Saying.
En este verso.
In this verse.
Perdón, diciendo, no leí el texto. Éxodo 20, perdón.
Saying in Exodus 20.
Perdón. En Éxodo 20 nos habla de los 10 enunciados.
He speaks to us in regards of the 10 enunciated.
Traducidos también mal hecho como los 10 mandamientos.
Wrongly translated as the 10 commandments.
Los 10 enunciados o las 10 palabras.
The 10 words or the 10 enunciated.
Que el Eterno habló a las naciones.
That he spoke to the nations.
Porque junto con el pueblo de Israel.
Because together with the people of Israel.
Salieron representando las 70 naciones.
Many came out representing the 70 nations.
En Egipto estaban cautivos no solo el pueblo de Israel.
In Egypt, not only Israel was captive.
En aquel tiempo, Egipto era el gobierno mundial.
Egypt in back then was the power of the world.
Ellos querían tener cautivo a todo el mundo.
They wanted to have everybody, all the world, under captivity.
Así es que se dieron la tarea.
So they wanted to.
De tomar una persona de cada una de las 70 naciones.
So they took one person of each of the 70 nations.
Digo una persona como algo simbólico, porque say, por lo menos una persona.
I say one person as a symbolism because at least one person.
Querían para tenerla esclavizada en ellos.
They wanted at least one person to have them under slavery.
Para mostrar al mundo que ellos eran el poder.
To show the world that they were the power.
Y cuando el pueblo de Israel salió de Egipto,
and when Israel came out of Egypt,
muchos lo siguieron.
Many followed them.
Personas que no eran judías.
People that were not Jew.
Que habían visto el poder de Dios.
That had seen his power.
Y habían creído.
And that had believed.
En el rey de Israel.
In the king of Israel.
Salieron junto con el pueblo.
They went out together with the people. They followed them.
Y empezaron a seguir al Dios verdadero.
And they started to follow the true.
Y entre ellos iba por lo menos uno de las 70 naciones.
And in amongst them at least one of the 70 people 70 nations was.
So cuando el pueblo de Israel llegó al monte Sinai.
So when the people of Israel came to Sinai.
Y el Señor les entregó la Torá.
And he gave to them Torah.
Se la entregó a todas las naciones.
He gave it to all of the nations.
E incluso en los comentarios.
Inclusively in the commentaries.
Rabínicos.
The rabbinic commentaries.
Nos enseñan que esos mandamientos.
They show us that those commandments.
Fue para todas las naciones.
Were for all the nations.
Y por si fuera poco eso.
And even then.
Lo podemos ver hoy.
We can see it
en
today.
Lo natural.
In the natural.
Todas las naciones.
All the nations.
Conocen.
Know.
Y saben esto.
And know these commandments.
Y los han establecido,
and they have established
en sus decretos y
constituciones. In their decrees and constitutions.
En ninguna parte del mundo puedes matar.
Nowhere in the world you can't kill.
Porque está prohibido.
Because it's prohibited.
¿De dónde lo aprendieron?
Where did they learn
it? ¿De dónde
it?
Lo sacaron?
Where did they get that out of?
Y podemos seguir leyendo los mandamientos y se dan cuenta.
We can keep reading the commandments and see.
Que los podemos ver alrededor del mundo.
That we can see around the world.
Porque eso es lo que el Señor quería.
Because that's what he wanted.
Así es que cuando él dice que él habla a las naciones,
so when he says that he speaks to the nations,
nos habla a todos los que hoy estamos aquí.
He speaks to all of us that are here.
Porque después de esas 70 naciones surgieron más.
Because after those 70 nations, more came.
Y estos mandamientos son para todos.
And these commandments are for everybody.
Así es que el Señor.
So then, Elohim,
en el versículo 1,
in chapter 1,
habla al pueblo.
He speaks to the people.
Pero la Torá, en lugar de poner el nombre sagrado,
but Torah, instead of putting the sacred name,
usa el nombre Elohim.
It uses the name of Elohim.
Habló todas estas cosas.
He spoke all of these words,
presentándose a ellos.
Showing to them,
como el Elohim,
showing himself to them as the Elohim.
Y la Mishnah nos enseña,
and the Mishnah teaches us,
¿por qué utilizó el nombre Elohim?
Why did he use the name Elohim
en lugar del sagrado nombre?
Instead of the sacred name.
Ya que en esta misma parasha,
since in this same parasha,
todas las veces que utiliza el o se dirige a Dios,
since in this parasha, every time we read the word God,
utiliza el nombre sagrado.
The word, the sacred name is used.
Excepto en este versículo.
Except in this verse.
En este versículo usa el nombre Elohim.
In this verse, the Torah uses Elohim.
Los sabios dicen que en este momento, en este versículo,
the sages say that in this, at this moment, in this verse,
la palabra Elohim,
the word Elohim,
connota,
connotates,
juez,
judge.
No solo un Elohim, sino un Elohim que hace justicia.
Not just an Elohim, but an Elohim that makes justice.
Enseñándonos que él será el juez.
Showing us that he will be the judge.
Para aquellos que observen o no.
To those who observe or not.
Yireh bemoreh.
The event moreh.
Amén. So cuando usa la palabra Elohim,
so when the Torah uses the word Elohim,
nos enseña que él actuará.
It's teaching us that he will act
sobre toda humanidad, sobre over, toda la humanidad,
over all humanity,
como un juez,
as a judge,
juzgando y permitiendo,
judging and permitting
las consecuencias,
the consequences
de la desobediencia,
of the disobedience.
para toda la humanidad.
To all humanity.
Por lo tanto,
therefore,
estos mandamientos,
these commandments,
no son opcionales.
Are not optional.
Son requeridos.
These are required.
Para toda la humanidad.
To the entire humanity.
Contrario a lo que muchos enseñan.
Against to what everybody else teaches.
Contrario a lo que muchos predican hoy día.
Against to what everybody else are teaching, preaching today.
Inclusive muchos judíos.
Even many Jews.
Mesiánicos incluso.
Messianic as well.
Enseñan que la Torah no es para todos.
They're teaching that the Torah is not for everyone.
Que la Torah es solo para los judíos.
The Torah is only for the Jew.
Y que los gentiles no tienen por qué observar
and
la Torah.
And the Gentiles have no reason to observe the Torah.
Y no tienen ni por qué observar Shabbat.
And that they shouldn't even observe Shabbat.
Yo quiero mostrarles hoy.
I would like to show you today.
Que aún Rashi.
That even Rashi.
Estaba en desacuerdo de eso.
Was in disagreement with that.
Vamos a leer algunos comentarios
We're
de Rashi.
We're going to read a couple of commentaries.
Y de la Mishnah.
From Rashi and Mishnah.
Para que vean cómo nos enseñan los sabios.
So you'll see how the sages teach.
Que aún nosotros tenemos obligación.
That even us now we have the obligation.
De observar y cumplir.
To observe and to comply.
Si es que queremos ser parte.
If we want to be part.
De las bendiciones del Eterno.
Of the blessings of the Eternal One.
Éxodo capítulo 12.
Exodus 12.
Versículo 48.
48.
Aquí veremos para quién son requeridos estos
Here
mandamientos.
We'll see who these commandments are required for.
Vamos a leer Éxodo 12:48.
Exodus 12:48. We're going to read it. Mm-hmm. And when a stranger dwells with you and wants to keep the Passover to the Lord, let all his males be circumcised, and then let him come near and keep it. And he shall be as a native of the land, for no uncircumcised person shall eat it.
So, antes de entregarles la Torah,
so before he gives them the Torah,
se celebró Pesach.
Pesach was celebrated.
Y había requisitos para celebrar
Pesach. And there were requirements to be able to celebrate it.
Y uno de los requisitos más importantes.
And one of those, the most important, one of the most important requirements.
Para celebrar Pesach.
To celebrate Pesach.
Era la circuncisión.
Was the circumcision.
Ningún incircunciso.
No one who was uncircumcised.
Puede tomar del Pesach.
Could have of the Pesach.
Pero aquel extranjero,
but that stranger,
y ahí nos habla de que había extranjeros, de que había gente que siguió al pueblo de Israel.
And that shows us that there were strangers, unnative ones that were following them.
Y esos extranjeros y querían participar de las bendiciones del pueblo de Israel.
And those strangers that wanted to participate
del pueblo de Israel, de las bendiciones del pueblo
of the blessings of Israel.
Tenían que circuncidarse.
Had to circumcise themselves.
Y al circuncidarse,
and by doing so,
el Señor les menciona,
he mentioned to them,
que serán como un nativo,
that they will become or be
de la tierra,
like a native of the land.
Ahora, acerca de esta frase,
now,
que será nativo,
now in regards of this phrase,
de
he shall
tierra,
be as a native of the land.
Rashi explica
Rashi teaches
que esto se refiere
that it refers
a que será como otro judío.
That the person will be just like another Jew.
Y ustedes verán que en el comentario siguiente
and in the next commentary
en el siguiente versículo
in the next verse
Rashi explica
Rashi explains
que esto se refiere
that this is actually referring
a todos
to
los mandamientos
all of the commandments
descritos aquí
described here
incluyendo Shabbat.
Including Shabbat.
Es interesante.
It is interesting.
Tuve una conversación con una persona que es un judío ortodoxo, pero cree en el Señor.
I had a conversation with an orthodox Jew but believes in the Lord.
Y él piensa que podemos cumplir los mandamientos, pero no Shabbat.
He thinks that we can comply with the commandments but not Shabbat.
Tengo obligación de cumplir el mandamiento que dice no matarás.
I have the obligation to comply with the commandment that says do not kill.
Pero no tengo obligación de observar entonces el Shabbat.
But I don't have the obligation to observe Shabbat.
No tiene sentido.
It doesn't make sense.
Pero veamos qué dice la Mishnah y veamos qué dicen los comentarios de Rashi al respecto.
But let's see what the Mishnah says and what Rashi says in regards of that.
Éxodo capítulo 12, que es el siguiente versículo, el 49.
Exodus 12:49, which is the following verse.
Vamos a leerlo.
We're going to read it. And it says, one law shall be for the native born and for the stranger who dwells among you.
Una sola ley. Ahora muchos dicen que esto solo se refiere al día de Pesach.
One law. But many say that this is only referring to Pesach.
Porque dicen que la misma ley, porque está hablando de Pesach.
Because they're saying that the same law, because it's speaking about Pesach.
Se aplicará tanto al nativo como al extranjero que habita entre ustedes.
Will apply also as well as to the stranger as to the native.
Pero Rashi, abajo de este versículo.
But Rashi, under this verse.
Comenta que esto aplica para todos los mandamientos.
Comments that this is for all of the commandments.
Porque el extranjero que ha venido.
Because the stranger that has come.
Se ha circuncidado.
Has circumcised.
Y al hacerlo.
And by doing so.
Se ha convertido.
Has become.
Parte del pueblo de Israel.
Part of the people of Israel.
Ahora todos nosotros entendemos.
Now all of us understand
que sí tenemos
that we do
la
have the obligation
de circuncidarnos
to get circumcised
para entrar a su pueblo.
To be able to come into his people.
Por cierto, varones, allá tenemos un cuartito.
Therefore,
we have ready everything for you guys.
There's a room over there.
La buena noticia.
The good news.
Es que también
is that
podemos circuncidar
that we can
otra parte de nuestro
circumcise
cuerpo,
another part of our body.
Y es nuestro corazón.
And that's our heart.
Es nuestro yo.
Is our me, my I.
Cuando tú te atreves a circuncidarte,
when you dare to circumcise
y no ser
yourself,
ya tú,
and not in be,
sino
not you anymore,
que él sea en ti,
but to allow him to be in you,
entonces te conviertes.
Then you convert yourself.
Y eres parte del pueblo de Israel.
And you are part of the people of Israel.
No eres más un incircunciso.
You are no longer an uncircumcised.
Eres un circuncidado.
You are a circumcised
de la casa de Israel.
Of the house of Israel.
En las naciones.
In the nations.
Aleluya.
Hallelujah.
Se espantaron algunos hombres.
Some men got a little bit scared.
Les vi la carita preocupada.
He says he saw your faces.
Aleluya. Bendito. Es interesante.
It is interesting
para mí saber
to me to know
cómo cuando la mayoría de los hispanos
how when most of the Hispanics
éramos y seguíamos a la religión común
were and we were part of the common religion
no obedecíamos ni seguíamos
we were not obeying or following
el segundo mandamiento
the second commandment.
El segundo mandamiento dice no te harás ídolo ni semejanza alguna de lo que está arriba en el cielo ni abajo en la tierra ni en las aguas debajo de la tierra.
The second commandment says, you shall not make yourself a carved image, any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth.
Pero es interesante para mí ver que cuando nos convertimos al cristianismo,
but it is interesting to me that when we become Christians,
no solo obedecemos este mandamiento,
we're not only obeying this commandment,
sino predicamos,
but we preach,
enseñamos,
and we teach,
y rechazamos a todos los idólatras que hay en el mundo,
and we reject all of the idolaters that are around the world.
Los criticamos y queremos que obedezcan este mandamiento.
We criticize them and we want them to obey this commandment.
Pero nos olvidamos,
but then we forget,
del cuarto,
of the fourth one.
No observamos el segundo.
We didn't observe the second one.
Pero ahora no se observa el cuarto.
But now we're not observing the fourth one.
No tiene sentido.
Does it make sense?
El cuarto mandamiento.
The fourth commandment.
Es el único mandamiento.
It's the only commandment.
Que dice que recuerdes.
That says to remember.
Y lo curioso es que es el único mandamiento.
And the interesting thing is that it's the only commandment.
Del cual se le ha olvidado.
Of the one that has been forgotten.
La Mishnah enseña
the Mishnah teaches
que cuando el Eterno dio estos 10 enunciados,
that when the Eternal gave us these 10 enunciated,
los dio en un solo enunciado.
He gave them all in one enunciated.
Lo cual es imposible para el ser humano.
Which is impossible for the human.
Sin embargo, esto nos enseña
however, this teaches us
que esta o cada una de las frases mencionadas aquí
that each of the phrases that are mentioned here
aplican para todos los demás.
Apply to all of the rest.
Por lo tanto, si en el cuarto dice recuerda,
therefore, if on, in the fourth one it says remember,
nos enseña que aplica para los
it
demás.
Teaches us that it applies to the rest.
Y es triste,
and it is sad,
porque muchos ni siquiera conocen estos 10.
Because many don't even know these 10.
Acuérdate del día de reposo.
Remember the Sabbath day.
Lo tradujeron de esa manera.
They,
día de reposo.
They translated as the day of rest.
Y las Biblias en español no ponen Shabbat.
And the Bibles in Spanish they don't write Shabbat.
Y ellos dicen, bueno, el día de reposo para aquí es el domingo.
Well, here the day of rest for here is the Saturday, Sunday.
Por lo tanto, estoy obedeciendo lo que ahí
therefore,
dice.
I am obeying.
Y ese es el problema con muchas traducciones.
And that is a problem with many translations.
Por lo menos en inglés.
At least in English.
O por lo menos en la New King James.
Or New King James.
No conozco la King James. Pero en la New King James le dejaron la palabra Shabbat.
In the New King James, they left the word Shabbat.
Lo cual se hace más claro aún.
Which it makes it more clear.
Entender que este es el día del Señor.
To understand that this is the day of the Lord.
Se hace más claro entender.
It makes it more clear.
Que debemos obedecer.
That we need to obey.
Este mandamiento.
This commandment.
Como el día.
As the day.
Que el Señor nos entregó.
That he gave to us.
Para que este día se lo dedicáramos a él.
So that this day can be dedicated to him.
Por eso dice recuerda.
That's why it says remember.
Sin embargo.
However,
van a ver que más adelante,
later or ahead,
en otra cita bíblica,
in another verse,
nos dice que
it
lo guardemos.
Says that we should keep it.
Sin embargo, Rashi dice,
but Rashi says
que es parte de este mismo enunciado.
That it is part of this same enunciated.
La Mishnah dice, de Mishnah.
The Mishnah says
que cuando dice recuerda,
it states that when it says remember,
es un enunciado de carácter activo.
When it says remember, it is an enunciated of active character.
Ya que se refiere al cumplimiento de los preceptos de Shabbat.
Since it is referring to the compliance of the Shabbat precepts.
Mientras que en Devarim 5:12,
while in Devarim 5:2,
dice guarda,
it says keep,
y se refiere a las prohibiciones,
referring to the prohibitions
del día,
of the day,
y por ello tiene carácter pasivo,
and therefore it has a passive character.
Pero Rashi dice que ambos,
but Rashid says
that tanto, both, tanto recordar y guardar,
both to remember and to keep,
son complementos,
are complements,
y no contradictorios,
and not contradictions.
Lamentablemente,
unfortunately,
muchos han hecho separación de los
many
dos.
Have made separation of both.
Y se atreven a decir,
and they dare to
que
say
los gentiles pueden recordar el
that
Shabbat,
the Gentiles can remember the Shabbat,
pero no guardarlo,
but not keep it.
No hay complemento en eso.
There's no complement in that.
E incluso,
inclusive,
ustedes saben,
you know,
que se han hecho demasiados mandamientos para Shabbat.
That there's a there were many commandments or rules made to Shabbat.
Muchos melajot.
Many melajot.
Melajot. Hechos por rabinos.
Made by rabbis.
Y han habido grandes discusiones.
And there has been great discussions.
Acerca de esos melajot.
In regards of those melajot.
Las mayores discusiones se dieron entre Shammai y Hillel.
The greatest discussions were between Shammai and Hillel.
Shammai decía que Shammai, no podías caminar después de la fuente.
Shammai said that you couldn't walk after the fountain.
Y Hillel decía que tú no podías caminar fuera de los muros de Israel.
And Hillel said that you couldn't walk outside of the walls of Israel.
Lo cual tenía para mí más sentido.
Which, for me, it had more sense.
Porque él quería que se quedaran dentro de los muros de Israel
he
para
wanted
celebrar
for
Shabbat.
Them to stay within the walls of Israel to celebrate Shabbat.
Podemos ver incluso
we can also see
que nuestro Señor siempre estuvo en contra
that our Lord Yeshua was against
estuvo en contra de esos mandamientos rabínicos.
He was against those rabbinical commandments.
Shamaíticos. De Shamay.
Shamaíticos.
So, en contra de los mandamientos de Shamay.
So, against the commandments of Shamay.
Cuando le dijo al paralítico, levántate.
When he told the one that was paralyzed.
Toma tu cama y camina.
Get up. Pick up your bed and walk.
Me imagino a los discípulos de Shabbat, de Shamay rodeando ahí.
I imagine the disciples of Shamay
y
going
diciendo,
around
¿cómo es este que le dice que
and
tome
saying,
su cama?
Why is this, how is he telling this guy to pick
y
up his
camine.
Bed and to walk?
Shamay nos ordenó que eso no era así.
Shamay told us that that wasn't like that.
Pero Yeshua les estaba enseñando.
But Yeshua was teaching them.
Que no eran los mandamientos de Shamay los que
that it wasn't
seguir.
The commandments of Shamay that they should follow.
Sino los del Padre.
But of the Father.
Tal y como lo dicen las Escrituras.
Exactly as the word says it.
Así es que no se confundan.
So don't get confused.
Con los melajot
with the melajot
de los alajot
of the alajot
los mandamientos del Señor
with the commandments of the Lord
concernientes a Shabbat
concerning to Shabbat.
Él dice que no hagamos trabajo de siervos en Shabbat.
He said to not do works of servants on Shabbat.
Y nos enseña que lo más importante en Shabbat
and he tells us that the most important thing in Shabbat
es estar delante de su presencia
is to be in His presence
en un ambiente familiar.
In a familiar a family environment.
Es por ello que también
that's why
nosotros celebramos
we celebrate
alegres
this such
nosotros celebramos alegres tan grande suceso y amamos la Torá y deseamos con todo nuestro corazón obedecerla.
That is why we also celebrate this such great event in a joyful manner. We love Torah and we desire to obey it with all of our heart.
Amén. Y por eso hoy estamos aquí, ¿no es cierto?
And that's why we're here today, correct?
Celebrando una de las fiestas más importantes.
Celebrating one of the most important feasts.
¿Cuántos se gozan que tienen
How
la Torah?
How many are joyful that you have Torah?
Hi people. Aleluya. Mucha gente no tiene ese privilegio.
Many people don't have that privilege.
Tener la Torah en aquellos tiempos.
To have the Torah back in those days.
Era muy costoso.
It was very hard, very expensive.
Solo los ricos tenían un papiro.
Only the rich ones had
porque era de piel, era de piel de animal.
Because it was made out of animal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Era difícil tenerla.
It was hard to have it.
Y hoy tenemos el privilegio de tenerla.
And today we have the privilege to have it.
Hasta en los electrónicos.
Even in the electronic
Pero también
devices.
Llegará el día.
But one day
en que no podamos tener.
Will come when we won't be able to have it.
Así que somos un pueblo privilegiado.
So
una generación
are a privileged
privilegiada.
People, a generation that
de
is privileged.
Tener la Torah entre nosotros.
To be able to have the Torah here with us.
Y lo más importante,
us.
La Torah viva.
And the most important, the Torah that's alive.
Yeshua HaMashiach.
Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen.
Ahora sabemos que nadie ha podido guardar todos los mandamientos agradando al Padre.
Now we know that that no one has been able to please the Father by keeping the Torah.
Excepto el Hijo.
Except the Son.
Y por medio de él.
And through him.
Fue enviada la solución.
The solution was sent.
A sus seguidores.
To his followers.
A sus talmidim.
His talmidim.
Alrededor de 1500 años después de celebrarse el primer Shabbat.
1500 years after the first Shavuot was celebrated
en el Sinaí,
at Sinai,
Yeshua le dio a sus talmidim, le dijo a sus talmidim,
Yeshua told his talmidim
que recibieran poder,
that they will receive power.
Diga conmigo poder.
Say with me, power.
Recibieran poder cuando viniera el Espíritu Santo
that they'll
sobre
receive
ellos.
Power when the Holy Spirit would come upon them.
Hechos 1:8.
Acts 1:8.
Pero recibirán poder cuando el Espíritu Santo venga sobre ustedes y me serán testigos en Jerusalén, en toda Judea, en Samaria y hasta los confines de la tierra.
Acts 1:8. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witness to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth.
Ahora, de acuerdo con Juan,
now, according with John,
el Espíritu Santo ya les había sido entregado.
That Ruach HaKodesh was already been given.
Entonces, ¿a qué se refiere cuando dijo que el Espíritu vendría sobre ellos?
So what does he mean when he says that the Spirit would come upon them?
Juan 20:22
John 20:22
dice, después de decir esto, sopló sobre ellos y les dijo, reciban el Espíritu Santo.
One second.
Yo creo que está en otra. Oh, no se ve. Okay. Aquí léelo.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so John 20:22 says, when he said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit."
Yo creo que en el Sinaí con la Torá,
I believe that at Sinai with the Torah,
les dio el poder de ser una nación para él.
He gave them power to be a nation for them.
Y cuando vino sobre ellos el Espíritu Santo,
and when the Holy Spirit came upon them,
les dio el poder,
he gave them the power,
de agradar al Padre,
to please the Father,
en todo
by
lo que
obeying
es
him
para él,
in everything that is great to him.
Ya que sin el Espíritu Santo,
since without the Holy Spirit,
nadie podía cumplir,
no one could comply,
nadie podía complacer al Padre,
no one could please the Father.
Sin el Espíritu Santo,
without the Holy Spirit,
Pedro negó al Señor.
Peter denied the Lord.
Tenían temor de morir por él.
They had fear to die for him.
No tenían el denuedo, la valentía.
They didn't have the braveness.
Aún no tenían ese poder.
They didn't have that power yet.
Habían recibido el Espíritu Santo.
They had received the Holy Spirit.
Pero no habían sido bautizados.
But they hadn't been baptized.
En el poder del Espíritu
de Dios. In the power of his Spirit.
Que es algo totalmente diferente.
That's something totally different.
Y por eso el Señor les dijo, se van a quedar allí.
And that's why he told them, you will stay here.
Hasta que reciban ese poder.
Until you receive that power.
¿Y cuál era el propósito?
And what was the purpose?
De ser testigos en las naciones.
The purpose was to be witness to all nations.
Porque con el poder del Espíritu,
because with the power of the Spirit,
podemos ser testigos,
we can be witness,
y hacer discípulos,
and make disciples.
Porque si no hacemos discípulos,
because if we don't make disciples,
aún no hemos recibido ese poder,
we haven't yet received that power.
Somos infructíferos,
we are not fruitful,
y estamos muertos,
and we're dead,
y tenemos que vivir para él,
and we have to live for him,
a través del fuego,
through the fire,
del Espíritu de Dios,
of the Spirit of Yahweh.
El poder del Espíritu, el poder que el Espíritu Santo otorgó,
the power that the Holy Spirit bestowed,
fue la habilidad de hablar en otras lenguas,
was the ability to speak in other languages.
Sin embargo, hay una lengua,
however, there is a particular language,
en particular, que todos deberíamos hablar,
that we should all speak.
Y es la lengua angelical.
And it is the angelic language.
Descrita por el Rab Shaliach o Rab Shaul.
Described by Shaliach Rab Shaul.
En el capítulo 13.
In chapter 13.
De la primera carta a los Corintios.
Of the first letter to the Corinthians.
¿Cuántos recuerdan eso?
How many of you remember that?
Dice el verso 1.
It says in verse 1.
Si yo hablara lenguas humanas y angélicas, pero no tengo amor, ha llegado a ser como metal que resuena, un címbalo que retiñe.
Though I speak with the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I have become sounding brass of a clanging cymbal.
Sí, lenguas humanas.
human language.
Pero hay lenguas angelicales.
But there's also angelical language.
So yes. Cuando estaban ese día, en día de Shavuot.
So when they were there on Shavuot.
El mismo día que 1500 años les había sido entregada la Torah.
That same day when 1500 years before Torah was given to them.
Y vino sobre ellos.
And came
la Ruach
over them.
HaKodesh,
the Ruach HaKodesh. When the Ruach HaKodesh came over them.
Todos empezaron a hablar en otras lenguas.
All started speaking in other languages.
Empezaron a hablar en otros idiomas.
They started speaking in other languages.
Y hablaban a los que no eran de allí, a otras naciones.
And they were speaking to the ones that were not from the same nation.
Y estaban sorprendidos de que el evangelio se decía en su propia lengua.
And they were surprised that the word was being given to them in their language.
Pero hay una lengua que aquí no está descrita sino hasta el capítulo 13 por el apóstol Pablo.
But there is one language here that is not described until after in chapter 13.
Y es la lengua angelical.
And it is the angelical language.
Y así yo puedo separar entre el don de lenguas.
And that way I can separate between the
gift
of tongues.
Y el bautismo del Espíritu
Santo.
And
the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Donde todos tenemos que tener ese bautismo.
Where we all have to have that baptism.
Donde todos podemos hablar esa lengua angelical.
Where we all can speak that angelical language.
Amén.
Amén.
No voy a mencionarles a Marcos capítulo 18.
In Mark chapter 18.
Porque dice allí que en mi nombre hablarán lengua. ¿Recuerdan ese texto?
Do you remember that
Marcos 18
text, Mark 18:17-18.
No voy a hablarles de ese versículo.
I'm not going to speak to you about that verse.
Ya que en los papiros originales.
Since the original transcripts.
Esos textos no existen.
Those texts did not exist.
Solo está hasta el verso 8.
It's only up to verse 8.
Los 12 versículos restantes no existen.
The following 12 were not there.
Por eso no vamos a ir a esos versículos.
That's why we're not going to go to those verses.
No quiero decir que eso sea mentira.
I'm not wanting to say that that's a lie.
Pudieron sacarlo de algunos testimonios.
It could have been that they were taken out of testimonies.
Pero no existen las escrituras originales.
But they're not written in the original.
Lo que sí sé.
What I know.
Y lo que yo conozco.
What I understand
es que podemos ser bautizados con el poder del Espíritu
Santo.
That
we can be baptized with the power of the Holy Spirit.
Con la habilidad.
With the ability
de poder hablar
to speak
esas lenguas angelicales.
Those angelical languages.
Así es que si tú no has sido
so if you
investido
have not
de ese poder,
invested with that power,
hoy puedes.
Today you can.
¿Y qué mejor día?
And what better day
que Shavuot.
Than Shavuot.
Aleluya.
Hallelujah.
En el capítulo 14,
in chapter 14,
el Shaliach explica
explains
cómo son las lenguas angelicales,
how the tongues are,
y cómo las lenguas angelicales, nuestro espíritu, con las lenguas angelicales, nuestro espíritu ora y hay crecimiento espiritual.
How with the angelic tongues our spirit prays and there is spiritual growth.
Yo quiero que abra su Biblia un momento.
I want you to open your scriptures. For a moment.
Y para poder terminar,
and so that we can finish,
vamos a leer algunos textos.
We're going to read a couple of texts or verses
del capítulo 14,
from chapter 14
de Primera de Corintios.
Of First Corinthians.
So el apóstol aquí está hablando.
So the apostle here, he's speaking about
acerca de profetizar,
about prophesying,
y hablar en lenguas,
and about speaking in tongues.
Sin embargo, recordemos que en el capítulo 13,
but remember that in chapter 13,
está hablando de las lenguas angelicales.
He's speaking about the angelical language,
no de las lenguas terrenales,
not the earthly ones.
Y en el capítulo 14 él menciona,
and in chapter 14 he mentions,
y hace referencia,
and makes reference
a las lenguas angelicales,
to the angelical languages.
Versículo 2,
verse 2
del capítulo 14,
of 14.
Porque el que habla en lenguas no habla a los hombres sino a Dios.
Those who speak in strange tongues do not speak to others but to God.
¿Porque habla con quién?
Because you're speaking with whom?
Con Dios.
With him.
Y luego dice, pues nadie le entiende.
And then it says, because no one understands them.
So cuando tú hablas en estas lenguas angelicales,
so when you're speaking in these angelical languages,
la gente no te puede entender.
People cannot understand you.
Porque estás hablando con Dios.
Because you're speaking with him.
Versículo 4.
Verse 4.
El que habla en lenguas,
those who speak in strange tongues,
a sí mismo se edifica.
Help only themselves.
So Pablo decía que hablaba en lenguas más que todos.
So Paul said that he spoke in languages more than anyone.
Y mira quién era Pablo.
And look at who Paul was.
Si queremos crecer espiritualmente,
if we want to grow spiritually,
tenemos que dejar que la Ruach HaKodesh nos llene de su poder.
We need to allow the Ruach HaKodesh to fill us with his power.
Y esto no se hace con el entendimiento.
And this you do not do with your understanding.
Vamos al versículo 13.
Let's go to verse 13.
El Shalach Pablo dice, por tanto, el que habla en lenguas pide en oración para poder interpretar.
The person who speaks in strange tongues then must pray for the gift to explain what is said.
Así es que por una parte no nos entienden.
So for one part they don't understand us.
Pero sí es posible entenderla.
But it is possible to understand them.
Pidiendo ese don de interpretación.
Asking for that gift of interpretation.
Porque son lenguas angelicales.
Because they are angelical languages.
Versículo 14.
Verse 14.
El apóstol da un ejemplo.
The apostle gives us an example.
De qué es lo que debemos hacer.
Of what we should do.
Porque si lloro en lenguas,
for if I pray in this way,
mi espíritu ora,
my spirit prays,
pero mi entendimiento queda sin fruto.
But my mind has no part in it.
Eso significa que cuando estás orando en lenguas,
that means when you're speaking in tongues,
si no tienes el don de interpretación,
if you don't have the interpretation,
ni siquiera tú mismo te vas a entender.
Not even you will understand what you're saying.
Y no te preocupes por lo que estás diciendo.
But don't worry about what you're saying.
Porque te está guiando el Espíritu.
Because his spirit is guiding you.
Versículo 15.
Verse 15.
Entonces, ¿qué haremos? Dice el apóstol.
What should I do then?
Oraré con el Espíritu.
I will pray with my spirit.
Pero también oraré con el entendimiento.
But I will pray also with my mind.
So todos sabemos orar con el entendimiento.
So we all of us know how to pray with our understanding.
Pero no todos hemos recibido el poder.
But not all of us have received the power
para orar en el Espíritu.
To pray in the Spirit.
Orar en el entendimiento,
praying in understanding,
es hablar con el Señor,
is to speak with him,
acerca de lo que nosotros podemos entender,
about what we can understand.
Padre, te amamos,
Father, we
necesitamos
love you,
de ti,
we need of you,
glorifico tu nombre,
we glorify your name,
aleluya,
aleluya,
hurraba shaba kalaba yende rebekoto roba eva gema labasendo. Orar en el Espíritu,
to pray in the Spirit,
es orar,
is to pray,
sin que mi entendimiento,
without my understanding,
interfiera. Es una comunicación,
it is a communication,
directa,
it's a direct
de
communication,
mi espíritu,
between my spirit,
con el Espíritu,
with his spirit.
Cantaré con el Espíritu,
I will sing with my spirit,
pero cantaré también con el entendimiento,
but I will also sing with my mind.
Y él es el poderoso de Israel. Uraba salaben de la madre bashanda y no corraba shamala bayero. Con el entendimiento y con el espíritu.
With the understanding and the spirit.
Y se está llenando tu alma,
and
pero
your
se está
soul
llenando tu espíritu.
Is filling up, but
estás
your spirit is also filling
porque
up.
Estás comunicándote con él.
You are growing in the spirit because you are communicating with him.
Tú y él se están convirtiendo en uno en ese
you
momento.
And him are becoming one.
Wow. Aleluya.
Amen.
Dice la escritura en el verso 18.
In verse 18 it says,
doy gracias a Dios porque yo hablo lenguas más que todos ustedes.
I thank him that I speak in strange tongues much more than any of you.
Yo me imagino a Pablo,
I imagine Paul,
caminando esas grandes distancias,
walking all those great distances.
Y solo yendo,
and praying in the Spirit.
Hallelujah. Amado hermano, yo he ido en mi carro manejando.
I have been in my car
y de repente siento driving. El Espíritu de Dios sobre mí.
And all of a sudden I feel His Spirit.
Y empiezo a hablar en otras lenguas.
And I start speaking in other
y no language, sé cuántos de ustedes, tongues. Pero me he tenido que estacionar.
I don't know about you, but I have had to park.
Because I can feel the presence of the Holy Spirit in my life.
Porque puedo sentir la presencia del Señor.
I don't know how many of you can feel that when you are driving.
No
you
sé
have
cuántos
to park
pueden
your car
sentirlo.
Over there and keep praying for the Lord because the anointing is right there in your
Hallelujah.
Car.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen. I was crying. I couldn't drive. Y tienes que estacionarte
and then you have to park
para poder seguir hablando con
so that
el Señor.
You can keep speaking with
That's
him.
The power of the Lord.
Ese es el poder.
That's the power of the Holy Spirit.
Ese es el poder
That's
del Espíritu.
The power of the Ruach HaKodesh.
Ese es el poder de la Ruach HaKodesh.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. ¿Y sabes qué son esos, esas lenguas? ¿Sabes qué es ese poder?
And do you know what that power is? What those tongues are.
Versículo 22.
Verse 22.
Así que las lenguas son una señal.
So then the gift of speaking in strange tongues is a proof.
No para los que creen.
Not for the ones that believe.
Sino para los incrédulos.
But for the unbelievers.
Una señal.
A sign.
Para que ellos crean.
So that they may believe.
Que el Espíritu Santo.
That the Spirit, His Spirit. Lives in you.
Último versículo.
Last verse.
Versículo 39.
39.
Por tanto, hermanos míos,
so then, my friends,
anhelen el profetizar,
set your heart on proclaiming,
y no prohíban hablar en lenguas.
But do not forbid the speaking in strange tongues.
Hay un mal entendimiento.
There's a wrong understanding
acerca de hablar en lenguas.
Regarding speaking in tongues.
Y orar en lenguas.
And praying in tongues.
El contexto de este capítulo.
The context of this chapter.
También nos habla de profecía.
Also speaks to us about prophecy.
Solo que Pablo prohibió.
So what Paul prohibited.
Es que se profetizara en lenguas.
Is that you would prophesied in tongues
sin intérprete.
Without an interpreter.
Jamás prohibió
never
que se orara en lenguas
that you would pray in tongues
dentro de una iglesia.
In the church. It was never prohibited.
A menos que se profetizara.
Unless that there was prophesying.
Somos libres
we are free
de poder orar al Señor
to be able to pray to him in all moments
en nuestro espíritu.
In our spirit.
¿Cuántos les gustaría recibir ese
How
poder?
How many would you like to receive
si
that power?
Tienes,
if you don't,
si no lo has recibido aún.
If you don't have it, if you haven't received it yet.
Este es el momento preciso.
This is the precise moment.
Para que el Espíritu Santo.
That the Holy Spirit.
Venga sobre ti.
Would come upon you.
Ponte de pie conmigo.
Stand up with me.